comes the sun. Here comes the sun. And I say, it's alright. Hello everyone, my name is Kirsten Leshford and welcome to, or welcome back to, my channel, Kiki Jade. If y'all don't know, I never film on a camera. I always film on my iPhone, and I just got a new iPhone, so that's fun. The quality is crazy. I'm totally here for it. So if you can't tell from the title, today I am going to be kind of doing a Q&A style video. I'm going to be answering y'all's questions, talking about your first impressions or assumptions and stuff like that. So I'm really excited to film this. I filmed one of these videos a long time ago on my dance channel, so I'm excited to kind of come in with a little update to that and answer some more of your questions. All right, so the first one, oh, also this is my old phone. It's real like busted over here. That's why I got another one. But it's great, it still works. It's paid off, so I get to use it. And I'm excited because, like I said, I don't film on a camera. I like to film on my phone just so I can edit it quicker. So that's really exciting that I have this phone to use. I didn't have to like write any of the questions down or anything because now I have my other phone with me. I got two phones. All right, first impression. Oh my gosh, I love Bella with my whole heart. She also has a channel, so I hope to collab with her in the future. That would be really fun. Yeah, she said, first impression, you were so calm and kind and made me feel important. That makes me so happy. Honestly, I feel like that's all I want to do in life is to make people feel important. I can't remember what birthday it was specifically, but I do know my mom posted this really sweet post. Let me see if I can find it. But she said something that kind of has stuck with me that I wasn't really aware of. Okay, it's my 16th birthday. She said, she's one of the most kind, humble, and genuine people you'll ever meet. If you're lucky enough to know her, she'll make you feel like the best, most important, worthy person on the planet. So I didn't know that I made people feel like that. And I feel like sometimes I can come across like, I've gotten told lots of times that I seem very intimidating and mean in a way. I'm kind of shy and soft-spoken, so if I don't talk to somebody, it comes across or can come across aggressive or mean. But most of the time where those people are seeing me is before I compete, which don't even get me started on that. I can be very much focused and stoic, so it's not like intentional, it's just how it has to be for competition, at least for me, because I can't just go on stage and be it. Like, I need to be focused and stuff, so that's why some people think that. But I'm really happy when people do tell me that I come across really nice and sweet and very friendly. So yeah, that was a great one to start with. Okay, now we have an assumption. It says you are naturally flexible. Okay, I had to think about it for a second. So I'm just gonna go like by a body part, because flexibility can come in all sorts of like shapes and sizes. One person could be really flexible in their hips while someone else could be super flexible in their back. So let's just work from my feet up. Okay, I've worked super duper hard on my feet probably since I was like, I wanna say I started really trying when I was like 10. I am flat-footed. I'm not going to show you because I hate my feet, but I am very much flat-footed, which is not necessarily a great thing when you're wanting to be a dancer, because you want to have, you know, that beautiful arch so that all of your pictures come out really pretty and so that you never have to be told like, oh girl, point your feet or really work through that ankle. That is something that if you had an arch would be easier to avoid those sorts of comments. So I can't really necessarily pinpoint any specific critique that I used to get about my feet being bad. I just knew that because I was flat-footed because of my dad, that it was something I definitely needed to work towards. And I have a lot of stretches that I like to do and material that I like to give to the kids that I teach at my studio for privates. So if you guys want a video relating to, you know, maybe a stretching routine or how to improve your feet, something like that, I would love to give that to you all. Just let me know. But there's just so many things that I had to do and work on to help me improve my feet and my flexibility in my feet, because again, being flat-footed kind of presented a lot of challenges. It made my releve a little lower than it could have been, and just different things like that. So I really worked super duper hard on my feet to get them really good. So I definitely, to answer that question, was not naturally born with like this God-given talent with beautiful feet. Like, I actually really worked hard on that. So it makes me really happy when I get like lots of compliments on my feet and like my ballet training and stuff like that, because it makes me feel like all my hard work really paid off. And it wasn't an easy journey, but it was something that I knew that I wanted to have. Like, I always wanted to have like this gorgeous flexibility and beautiful feet and stuff like that. So it's something I'm glad that I put the effort in and worked towards, because now I honestly, it's kind of muscle memory now. So with all that hard work that I put into it, I go on stage and I don't even really have to think about like pointing my feet or like really stretching or through the ankle or anything like that. It just kind of happens because of all the hard work that I put into it prior. Okay, that was long. Working up. I'm hyperextended. I don't know how that came about. I don't know. Kind of sounds stupid, but I feel like I didn't always have hyperextension. I feel like it's just something not recently. Maybe like 3 years ago, realized that, or people would be like, you're hyperextended. It's never something that I was like, oh, I'm right out. Like when I started dancing, like everybody would tell me, oh my God, you're hyperextended. Do this, do that. Like, it was just something that like recently when I started choreographing, I'm like, oh, I could do this move. Like, that looks cool. And then it's just something that I like to stick with because I like the way it looks. So yeah, I didn't know I was hyperextended till recently. What's next? Hip flexibility. I have horrible hips. Hold on, I think I have to join my Zoom meeting. All right, now that that's done and over with, I ended on hip flexibility. So my hips were really good when I was younger, probably like when I started dancing up until like 12. From that point on, I feel like I didn't necessarily regress in my hip flexibility. It was just something that I had to work towards, whereas honestly back then I would just throw my leg up and call it a day. And I didn't have to put that much effort in. So I want to say, this is kind of a funny one. Back then, I feel like I had like a God-given ability with my hip flexibility. And now it's something that I have to like work towards and stretch a lot. If you ever see me before I go on stage, I'm only sitting like my frog stretch with my head down. That's just my go-to. Something that I would say I'm least flexible in right now is my hips. So yeah, I kind of want to say I was naturally flexible with my hips, but now I'm not, if that makes sense. Now on my back, I don't even think I was naturally flexible with my back. I just know that I was one of those kids who always wanted to like do back bends and learn all sorts of contortion tricks and just different things like that. So I kept practicing and playing around. If you ask my parents, I need to do a video with them one day. They could just tell you all these stories. But when I was younger, I would come into the living room and literally just like, while they were watching TV for like a couple hours, I would just be literally standing in a handstand for like an hour, or a headstand, elbow stand. I would work on lots of sorts of balances that kind of slowly improve your back flexibility. So I think I was 9 or maybe even 8 when I was really involved with like contortion, or like wanted to be a contortionist. So I want to say that helped improve my flexibility. I really just love to do stuff like that and would work on it a lot. So I don't really know if it was something that I got good at because of the practice that I put into it, or just because I was naturally flexible. So sorry, I can't help you with that. And I guess now my shoulder flexibility, that is something I'm naturally flexible in. Anytime that, like, you know, the basic like warm-ups where teachers are like, all right, like I did that, and like I've always been able to like bring my shoulder very far back. So basically, to summarize, I'm naturally flexible in my shoulders, and I used to be in my hips. I am not naturally flexible at having good feet. Legs or my back, I want to say. That was also a very long explanation. I am sorry, I probably will cut most of that out. All right, least favorite thing about COVID schooling. So, definitely not being able to see and hang out with my teachers and friends. Honestly, more of my teachers than my friends, only because it's not like I have a few of my teachers. I actually only have one teacher that I text because I'm like an NHS officer. I'm president. So I have to, like, that's the only reason why I have to have his number. But all of my other teachers, I obviously can't like just FaceTime them. Like, that would kind of be weird. So that's why I want to say, if I had to pick one thing, it would probably like not being able to hang out with my teachers, because I do FaceTime my friends a lot, which I'm so blessed for having technology, and the fact that they have it too, and so we're able to connect with one another is fabulous, and I'm so grateful. But yeah, I do miss my friends and like hanging out with them in person, and same for my teachers. I was always that kid growing up that would go eat lunch with the principal and teachers like that. So, and it wasn't because I had anything against the kids, I just always bonded really well with adults, and I still kind of do. But yeah, I miss just, I can't remember, like, the last time that I went back for a full day to school was probably, no, it wasn't even a full day, it was a half day, because it was our SAT testing day, and we were still being COVID compliant. I want to say this is, like, most of the kids, like, first time back at school since we left in March. So it was very much an experience, and I will never forget walking to my classroom that I was taking the SAT in, and we all had to walk the hall in one direction. So instead of like all of our teachers, you know, just sitting in their classrooms, they all came outside of their room and were just standing there, maybe trying to wait to see if they recognize any of the students that were walking by. And it just happened to be that all those teachers in that specific hallway were teachers that I either had or have met at one point at the school, or just like knew and loved. And it was just such a great experience. I felt like Miss America for a fat second. I was just like, it was really the best thing ever. I will not forget that. I remember texting my mom right after I took the SAT, because I couldn't use my phone, obviously. But the second that I got it back, I was like, Mom, that was such an experience. Like, I didn't even talk about the SAT. I was just talking about how, like, I got to see all of my favorite teachers and stuff, and it was so awesome. So yeah, that's kind of the crappy thing about online schooling, is I have to just see everybody on Zoom, and I can't just like go into lunch tutoring and just talk to everybody. I literally would never go into lunch tutoring just to like be tutored. I would just not be there for the tea or anything. Just, I would talk to them, and you know, I miss that so much. There's so many stories I could tell, but we have to say that for another video. Who are your favorite artists at the moment? Stay tuned for a January, like, songs I discovered video coming either next week or the week after. Just to keep it short and sweet, probably Taylor Swift. I always loved Dodie Clark. What a queen. Olivia Rodrigo, 12 out of 10. Zizz is always up there. Kind of love Garth Brooks right now. Today's inauguration day, so I just, before filming this, I watched the whole, like, presidential inauguration, and Garth Brooks sung Amazing Grace. That was just beautiful. Literally love that for him. Let me name one more. Oh, I always love that song, Glamorous by Fergie. I know this is real random. I wouldn't say she's like my favorite artist, but that's just a song that I love. And it just makes me feel like a queen. So I'll put Fergie up there just for that one song. All right. I'm probably going to answer like two more of these. I have so many. So I might need to do a part two of this video if y'all want that. Let me pick. All right. Do you have a boyfriend? I do not have a boyfriend, and I've never had a boyfriend. Oh, well, baby, are you my boyfriend? Come here. You don't want to be in it? You don't want to be in it? Oh, come here. Come be in it. Oh, Jesus. Come here. I'm trying to move you. Come scoot closer. He's mad at me. No, I don't have a boyfriend. I've never had a boyfriend. Actually, I need to give like a story. I need to do a story time video one day regarding boyfriends and stuff like that. But I only had a boyfriend for one day, and it's literally not even, I just like to say, cause like I literally never dated anybody. I want to say it was like first grade, and we were like doing this like friend group challenge with like me and my friends, and like we picked one guy to like date, but like it was supposed to be for like 24 hours, but it literally wasn't. It was like probably like 10 minutes, so like obviously that was just like a childish thing that we did. So no, I don't consider that my boyfriend, whoever that person was. Yeah, other than that, literally I've never ever had a boyfriend. It's never, I always get asked, this is kind of not the question that was asked, but another question that I get asked is like, why? I always blame it on like my drive, my focus, time management, and maturity. I just feel like I haven't met the right person yet, and I've never been somebody who feels like I have to be dating in high school or have to set this sort of timeline for myself. And I wanna give huge thanks to my parents for that, because honestly, they didn't live a very like traditional life, as one could say. So it kind of showed me that, you know, I turned out fine for them, I want to say. And things can work out as long as you're just like smart with your choices and you know the pros and the cons of things. And I feel like the cons have always outweighed the pros of having a boyfriend, at least for now. Do you want to be in the video or not? Come here. But I've just never pressured myself to date or anything like that, and I'm just very much happy and grateful. So, yeah. But I definitely do want to start, you know, finding one when I get into college and stuff like that. We'll see. I'm going to do a speed round of all of these. Favorite color, white. Favorite animal, lion or swan. Goal in life, I want to dance professionally. Hardest thing you've ever done, I'll save that for another video. Let me go to my YOLO, let's find more. Hi, boys. Oh, should not be the last questions. Are you over it? We're over it. Okay. He's my puppy. Do you want to do this outro with me? Alright. Thank you guys for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed. I definitely did not get through all of the questions by any means. So if you want a part two of this, let me know. But yeah, if you don't want this video, you can comment more video suggestions that you have. I have a lot coming up that I'm excited to film, so stay tuned for that. And I love you all so much. If you liked this video, give it a like. If you didn't, don't do anything at all. And I'll see you guys next week on Wednesday. Bye. Mm-hmm. I'll say bye, mommies. Mm-hmm. Bye. See you guys next week. You'll always be my only guiding light.